a glass door, the one that's glazed over, where you can see movement but can't make out the details. A hum noise can be heard within, the ring of a telephone, people chatting, coffee being slurped in hopes to compensate for the lack of sleep, laughter. Behind this door is a team of news reporters who have been summoned by their boss, Mr. Das, to the conference room. He's seething with rage.
This has gone too far. This charade of yours is just too much. You really need me to spell it out? Fine, superheroes. The ones that you created with your wild imagination. Early bee who makes sure you're never late. Mosquito man who sucks away stress. Drop man who drops you to where you need to go. Wardrobe queen who helps you choose the perfect outfit. Sibling stopper who stops fights between siblings. Silky smoothie who ensures you never have a bad headache. Anti-guest man who stops unwanted guests from showing up. And let me not forget, taste bud tweaker who makes school food delicious. Ridiculous!
What?
Why don't you state your headlines and I'll read the comments we've received on Twitter. Oh wait, I mean Instagram. Can't believe anything on Twitter these days, especially those blue ticks.
Early B, rescue student, born in the midnight oil. On time for exams.
Excuse me, isn't that what alarms are for?
Silky smoothie makes Justin Bieber a poly. Believers outraged.
Mobs buying wigs and hiding trimmers as believers shave their heads in support of Justin Bieber.
Rockman flies Nama to US for an emergency meeting during the pandemic. Violates no flight zone.
Rockman, will you take me to the LV Tower in Paris, please? All my friends have the latest new bags. So not fair.
Wardrobe queen chooses perfect birthday outfit or not. Claims just for dreams.
North, south, east, west, whatever North wears is the best. We don't need you, wardrobe queen.
Sibling stopper solves mega fight between William sisters.
Yeah, right. What did you promise to give them to kiss and make up? Matching tennis rackets?
Anti-guest man prevents 20 FBI agents from storming into Donald Trump's house.
Politicians are using superheroes to dodge the law.
Mosquito man boosts medical industry, sucks tension from doctors and nurses.
Next thing we know, there'll be a bee man stinging happiness into everyone.
Tasteman tweaker creates school food truck. Kids scream, it's addictive.
Parents' hands full with kids demanding the latest iPhones and extended TV time. Now all they eat is junk from this food truck. FSAII, what are you doing about this? Ah, latecomers. As you can see, you've made a mockery of this prestigious establishment. And so, it gives me the greatest pleasure to say, you're fired.
What?
Please, Mr. Das, don't do this. I'm innocent. They made me do it.
I just took a loan to buy a new house.
And my dogs require their weekly grooming, gourmet dog food, and new clothes. Just look at how cute he looks in these Gucci dog shoes.
My decision is final. But you will be assigned one last task. Go to the junkyard, kachra jagah.
Huh?
Silence. As I was saying, you will go to the kachra jagah and look for something interesting to write about. The owner is my brother-in-law and my wife won't stop nagging me till it's done. So, get on with it. Is a rather eccentric character indeed. At every family function that my wife drags me to, he manages to find me and tells me what strange and interesting things he's come across in his enchanted junkyard. Really? Enchanted? And he smells. Ugh. And of course, my wife chips in saying that I'll write an article about it. I've been putting it off and I finally have someone to do it for me. My poor reporters. This is going to be fun.
What are we even supposed to write about? This is worse than being fired.
Come on, cheer up. I'm going to attract all the negativity away with this magnet. I'm just like Mosquito Man.
Hey, look at this cool wig I found. I want not glamorous like Silky Smoothie. Let me take a closer look with this magnifying glass.
You! It's full of bugs.
See, there's a note underneath it.
Put me on and you will see a hot and juicy undercover story. Close your eyes and take your pick. You just have a minute, so be quick.
Whatever does this mean?
Let's go find the others and show this to them.
Can anyone else feel the ground shake? Wait for me!
The ground began to shake ever so slightly, and then everything went down. When the news reporters came back to their senses, it was bright again, as if nothing had happened. But actually, everything had. They just didn't know it yet.
What was that?
I'm not sure. Anyway, it's over. Can we get out of here? I'm starving.
This doesn't look like a junkyard. And I have no service here.
Look, people are traveling in horse-pulled carriages. Did we stumble upon a Hollywood set or something?
Look, a newspaper.
Choose different eras and unravel truths that have baffled humans for centuries.
This is bizarre. I wonder what it means.
Oh, I want to know how fire was discovered. I'm pretty sure it wasn't by rubbing those sticks together.
That never works.
And I want to know how Einstein uses 15% more of his brains than other humans. How is he so smart? And why does his head always stick up like that?
And I want to know the biggest mystery of all. How was the universe created? Was it a big bang or something entirely?
Let's get out of here and see what we discover.
I hope these stories will be good enough to get us back to our jobs.
We're underwater! Help!
Relax, you can breathe.
Look, we all can with these strange gills on our cheeks.
Hey, is that Einstein swimming over there?
No way! His hair is so straight and flat.
And he looks so silly in those massive shorts.
Oh no, he's being stung by an electric eel.
Look, his head is shutting off. He looks like a giant animal.
Shall we help him? Never mind.
And look at his hair. That's why it's always sticking up. It's because he got electrocuted by an eel.
Wait, is he solving a magic equation underwater? The eel made him a genius?
Cool, even I want to get stung too and become a genius.
Really?
Guys, the eel is coming this way. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, it's even scarier than Mr. Das.
One of them seems to have a broken spear. He's going and asking everyone who broke it.
Oh, the smoke coming out of his ears.
Oh yeah, and he's stuffing coconut husks in his ears to prevent the smoke from coming out. Oh dear.
Oh, a red flame just burst out of his ears. The coconut husks have got fire. Is this how fire was discovered?
Looks like they're happy not eating raw chicken anymore.
So this is how fire was discovered. And roast chicken too.
Come on, let's tell the others what we discovered.
Can we take a ride on it?
Calm down. You have to see who the captain is first. I am not getting on that if there are some creepy aliens riding it.
Is that Christopher Columbus? Wow, I definitely want to ride on that ship. I wonder if they're searching for America. But wait, who's that beside him?
Oh my god, it's Michelangelo, the famous artist who lost his sight painting the Sistine Chapel in Rome.
But what's Michelangelo doing? Is he painting circles?
And those circles are now turning into planets.
Oh yes, so it was Michelangelo who gave life form colors. He had an entire palette to choose from, and we are stuck with such boring colors.
Oh, stop your whining. You're missing the big picture. We just discovered how the universe was created. Christopher Columbus steers his ship through the universe, while Michelangelo paints the solar systems in the back.
No wonder the universe is always expanding.
But what are those rocks floating around with something written on them in shiny letters?
Maybe Michelangelo signed the rock, okay?
You can take a closer look with this magnifying glass I picked up at the junkyard.
Hey, look, there's a note on it.
Far is near and near is far. I show you things larger than they are. Are you ready for something grand? Hold me up with both your hands.
What's happening? I can't suffer from black.
What an incredible story! I wish I lived to tell this tale.
Mr. Daff will never believe you. Oh God, please save us.
Not God, Michelangelo.
News reporters get sucked into the black hole. They're transported to an advanced Earth.
Billboard there says when they are 2200. How cool! But I wonder, where on earth are we?
Judging by all these potholes and road constructions, I think we are still in Pune. These robotic dogs are such a nuisance. They've been listening and replying to all my conversations lately. It's so creepy.
I know, right? Hey, check out that stall. It says newsstand. What's the latest news in microlens?
Maybe we can figure out where we are and what's going on.
I don't see any newspapers here, only contact lenses. How strange. Anyway, let's put them on and see.
Wow, this has the news right in front of me. It's like I'm standing there watching things unfold. How cool.
Haha, check out this new headline. Excessive fertilizers, plant, swamp, city.
I wonder how this happened.
Excessive fertilizers, plants swarm cities.
A mistake in the chemical laboratory made plants grow 50 times faster.
The plants are strangling life as we know it, especially our robotic dogs.
And our firemen and woodcutters are exhausted. They just can't keep up with this workload. Hey, that plant is getting way too close. Watch out! I wonder how this is affecting the people. With their doors being in perfect condition, no one needed that tires change. But now, business is booming. Everyone needs the tires changed as plants keep puncturing them. It's too bad. So many dying in accidents. Hey, Ashley Samre.
As a scientist studying Mars, we are facing huge setbacks. None of our satellite data is coming in as our towers are getting choked by plants. It's like we're in the dark ages. Next week, we're supposed to send a crew to Mars to replenish the supplies of the population settled there. Whatever will we do?
I'm being swarmed by letters. Dear Mr. President, I'm hungry. The excessive fertilizers have only worked on useless plants and have stopped the growth of the food crops. What to do now?
Astronaut Undertaker, my job involves digging the ground. But because of this excessive fertilizer, my work has become so difficult. What usually takes me 1 hour, now takes me the entire day. And with so many deaths, I feel like lying under one of these holes myself.
That's enough bad news for one day. Who knew the end of humanity would be excess fertilizer?
Anyway, I'm hungry. Let's go grab some food to it.
Let's see what else our news reporters discover about 2200.
Can we please find find a hotel.
I agree. Let's look up some good places on our contact lenses.
Oh, look, the dark sleepy castle. Looks nice.
It does, but what's this? No pillows in any of the rooms. How can anyone sleep without a pillow?
Whoa, check out this news article. Pillow suffocating sleepers as heads too heavy, full of thoughts.
I wonder how this happened.
This just in. Pillows, the new killer?
Over to you, Anika.
Thank you, Shanae. So the story is a fine print Taj and IKEA. Apparently, IKEA delivered an order of pillows to Taj. They're responsible for having suffocated dozens of guests. The mansion of Taj is planning on suing IKEA.
Taj is also running into huge losses as everyone's cancelling their bookings. Even though the managers assured them that the matter has been resolved, no one really knows.
Let's hear a short clip of a conversation between the managers of Taj and IKEA.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
It's ma'am, by the way.
Sorry, sir. I mean ma'am.
So I ordered 450 pillows from you for our latest hotel, Sleepy Castle. And the people who slept in it died. They're dead. Never woke up. Suffocating their sleep. By your pillows. You need to explain.
That's not possible. Our pillows are made from the highest quality of cotton. That sounds like witchcraft to me.
Don't play games with me. Have you heard of Taj? Do you even know who I am? I'm the manager, and if this problem is not fixed, I will ensure that IKEA never sees the light of day again.
Okay, sir. See you in court.
So that's it from us, folks. We'll keep you updated on Taj and IKEA wars.
Stay tuned.
I wonder how this affects people. Aren't they afraid to sleep? Have they stopped using pillows?
My neck is killing me. I see dozens of patients every day with neck pains because they're too afraid to use pillows. When will this stop?
You're a doctor, you know. Why don't you come up with a solution?
Pillows aren't the only things people sleep on.
I could help you sell your product. You'll make millions.
You know what? Forget IKEA pillows. Use my rolled-up towels instead.
And I've come up with the perfect jingle for sales to increase. Want something to ensure a good night's rest? Buy our pillows. They're guaranteed to be the best.
Wow, that's really disturbing. Let's just sleep on towels. No more pillows for me.
No pillows for me either. Looks like I'll be cuddling you tonight.
I wish wardrobe people were here to help me choose what to wear.
Yeah, I think you're wearing your shirt inside out.
My neck hurts from sleeping on those horrible towels.
Tell me about it. I have a splitting headache. Mosquito man, please suck this tension away.
And we can't even book a hotel at Taj because of the whole IKEA scandal.
Excuse me, it's the Taj scandal, okay? Why are they blaming IKEA for the death of their customers?
Oh, hush the two of you. We're siblings, Fako, and you actually need him.
I know. Stop behaving like children. Besides, we have bigger things to worry about, like these robotic dogs.
Ah, relax. These dogs are harmless. But I don't think they should be used for security, that's for sure.
Yeah, these things have to be charged to love us. And I read online that they're selling our personal information to extraterrestrials.
I heard an actress's life got ruined because the dog overheard a conversation she had with the BFF and splashed it out of the internet. He was bored off stage at the Oscars. Poor thing.
That's so not true. Did you even see her hairdo? It was the worst. Too bad Silky Smoothie wasn't there to fix it.
If Auntie Gasman were here,
I got him to take these pesky robotic spider things away.
I think she might be listening. Look, one just fell into a pothole.
All this construction work is reminding me of the Pune Metro. Will this work ever end?
I just want to go home and eat some vada pav.
The food here is so bland.
I wish Taste Bud Tweaker were here to fix it.
Hey Adit, do you have the map that we found at the junkyard?
Yeah, why?
Avantika, you're a genius. The magnet? Why didn't I think of it before? The magnifying glass took us to the future.
And the wig took us to the past.
That means past, future. The magnet will take us back to the present.
Oh!
Hey Adit, look for the lottery ticket.
Though I may look small and meek, I'll bring to you what you seek. Hold me up and wave your hand, and I'll bring you a much desired land. A land that has everything you need. This is the land from your dreams.
Ah, forget it. Nothing's happening. Just stop standing around and find a way out of here.
So, the question is, were the superheroes real, or were they merely a figment of our news reporter's imagination? Something made up to get more fame, or get ahead in the game? And where did the enchanted objects come from? Let's head back to the present and take a look.
You're all late.
We're not late. You're early, Miss Early Bee.
No, I woke you up on time and reminded you to be here. Yet you're precisely 33 seconds late. Was it you, Silky Smoothie, who held everyone up, or was it you, Drop Man?
Well, excuse me, Miss Bee. This hair, you see, is perfection, okay? It takes a lot of TLC and time, you know.
Don't blame me. I spent all night delivering 122 pizzas all over the town. Look, Taste Bud Tweaker, go get us some food already. Isn't that your job? And no brinjal hidden in the food like last time.
Yes, yes, as Taste Bud Tweaker, it's my job to make all food taste good. Which is why I suggested meet at my restaurant at Kachra Jagga, the junkyard. But no, you chose this place. I'll talk to the chef and see what I can do.
You know, for someone who makes food taste better, this church was a good place to set up a restaurant where everyone loses their appetite.
What can I say? The rent was cheap.
Yo, hurry up! I was starving!
Ew, what are these uniforms these poor vendors are wearing? Here we go, someone called the fashion police. As wardrobe queen, I cannot let this slide. Here there, wait till I take your measurements.
My god, who chose to sit outside? There are so many mosquitoes.
Yeah, mosquito man, can't you do something about it?
I will say this only once. My job as mosquito man is to suck stress out of people. You know, like a mosquito sucks out blood. My job has nothing to do with mosquitoes.
Here's your food, fresh from the kitchen. Oh, and by the way, sibling stopper, the pesky child in the kitchen might want to catch.
Can't even enjoy a meal without being called on my duty. My advice, never have kids.
Silky Smoothie, your hair's in the food. Please, my only job is to have healthy, tangy hair. Maybe it's yours, Mosquito Man. Look, your dandruff is everywhere. Oh wait, your mosquito eggs?
Wow, what is that?
It sounds like a fire alarm. Taste my finger. Can you burn something?
Me? I would never do that. The sound is coming from her pocket.
It's my special alarm. That's strange. Strange how? It can only be activated when the magnet is near.
The magnet that takes you to the future? The magnet that we hid in the junkyard? You said it was a safe hiding place.
It is. It's disgusting. No one goes there except that loony, Mr. Sundar. He was so annoyed when the news reporters did an article on us and not him. Did you know his brother-in-law is the head of the news agency?
Stop your talking. What does that arm say?
It's a red alert from my phone. It's an alert from the future. There are some ancient news reporters that are unwelcomed and unwanted. And the citizens want their immediate removal or they will execute them.
Wait, these are the ones that wrote that article about us.
They must have found the magnet. But what are they doing in the junkyard?
I heard they got fired right in that article about us. They better need better hair too.
Mr. Sundar just texted. He said that they would write an article on him and his Sundar Kachra Jamal.
Wait, that's how they found our secret stash. What if we must have found a bigger magnifying glass too?
This is all your fault.
Me? You could have been the objects better.
You too. Stop this now. Well, we must go and help them. Let's go.
The superheroes who come from another planet arrive only when they see a world in turmoil. They successfully rescue our news reporters. After that exhilarating and harrowing journey to the past and the future, the news reporters are delighted to be back in the present. They take a few days to recover and contemplate on what to do next.
Job, no income. After our trip to the future, I feel like there's no hope. The world's a depressing place.
Yeah, real depressing.
I have so many bills to pay.
I don't have a dog to look after. Do you even know how expensive vets are?
At least they found a robot. And I have a party to attend, but nothing to wear.
Didn't you just buy new clothes?
Yeah, but it's on my Insta page and everyone's seen it before.
I've been thinking, what if we write to the superheroes to fix the problems in the present so that the future isn't so bad?
Aditya, you're a genius.
Our news reporters spend the next few days thinking of all the problems they encounter, and finally, after many drafts, they come up with a letter for our superheroes. The superheroes pondered over their dilemmas and had enlightening responses.
Homework and chores need to be done on time. So early, we remind us to set our alarms at night.
The milkman delivers the milk to you at dawn. He rings the bell and wakes you with his song.
My parents prefer my younger brother to me. Siblings, how put a stop to this partiality?
Your mother solves conflicts between your brother and you and gets you out of enough troubles. Woo-hoo!
The food we receive is cold and always late. Drop man, deliver it in a jiffy and change our fate. The Swiggy and Zomato guy will deliver the food as fast as they can. But remember to give him a hefty tip, cause he's a good man.
The competitors in the beauty pageant all look the same. Wardrobe queen make them unique so that they can rise to fame. Tailors can help you create your own fashion trends. They can whip up your heart's desires and put monotony to an end.
The taste of medicines is such a disappointment. Taste bud maker, stop resting and help in its improvement.
The chef will cook you a scrumptious three-course meal to hide the bitter taste of medicines and give you a 100% discount deal.
Dyeing my hair makes a limpid dead. Silky smoothie, make it so. I have a gray-free head.
A hair stylist will make all those grays go away. And if you're lazy, here's a can of L'Oreal color spray.
Problems surround us every day. Mosquito man, please suck the tension from our minds and replace it with motivation and courage if you would be so kind.
Family makes you laugh in your darkest hours. They make your worries run away. Such is their power.
I keep getting invited to unwanted parties and sleepovers. Auntie guest man, please convince my fake BFF to let me sleep under my own covers. Security guards keep you safe and sound from annoying brats. Just say the word and they'll shoo them away like unwanted dogs and cats.
You know, I feel like we're not needed anymore.
Parents are pretty good at stopping this from fighting.
True, and with Ola, Zomato, Swiggy, I do feel pretty useless. I mean, I get my stuff delivered from them too sometimes.
I still maintain that humans have terrible fashion sense.
Always the perfectionist. Have you tasted the desserts they come up with these days? Heaven, I must admit,
I've thrown quite a few of them myself.
And the hair since launcher do a pretty good job. Check out my hair. I have the most luxurious hair spa.
And everyone has problems. Nothing a good hair spa can fix. I think I'm going to get one too.
As for the unwanted guests, we are the unwanted ones. The people don't need us anymore.
I guess our work here is done.
What will we do now?
Well, there's always another planet to save. But we all can agree that planet Earth is in safe hands.
And with that, the superheroes depart our beloved planet and head on to their next adventure. But you must be wondering, whatever happened to the news reporters? Did Mr. Das give them their jobs back? No. But the news reporters weren't dejected and decided to start their own news agency, where they only report about good and happy news. Events that aren't reported about a young boy helping his neighbor, a teacher motivating her student, a parent sacrificing their career to spend more time with their kids, and so on. The real superhero is you, dear audience, and the little acts that you do every day are nothing less than super. Thank you. Introducing the stars of today's performance. First off, we have Adit, Adarsh, Anika, and Ali. Please put your hands together for the creative and spectacular Adit, the calm and thoughtful Adarsh, the riotous and energetic Anika, the lively and enthusiastic Ali. Thank you, children. Anushka Potar, Anushka Rathi, Arya and Avantika. Let the quiet and playful Anushka Potar. The lovely and dynamic Anushka Rathi. The spicy and tireless Arya. The industrious and spirited Avantika. Thank you, children. I now call Gargi, Myra, and Raha. Let's hear it for the sweet and vigorous Gargi. The powerful and loud Myra. The cool and tranquil Raha. Thank you, children. And last but not the least, we have Shania, Tanaya, and Yavi. We celebrate the pleasant and brilliant Shania. The cool and fabulous Tanaya. The animated and electrifying Yavi. Thank you, children. Thank you, parents, for being a wonderful audience.